everyone, welcome back. So today we're going to talk a little bit about my disability, about my illness. It's a little part of me, but it's not all of me. But for you guys to get to know me a little better, I thought that I would talk about it. So we'll start back when I first got sick. I was 11 years old and I got a brain tumor. And my parents took me to the hospital and they operated and they sent it off for biopsy, and then about a week or two later they came back and they said it was benign, it's not cancer. About a week after that, the tumor came back, but bigger, back in my brain. So my parents decided it was time for a second opinion. So they sent me down to Sick Children's Hospital in Toronto, which is Sick Kids for short. So when I went to Sick Kids, they ran more tests and they found out that I had a rare type of cancer. And it affects your bones and your tissue. And it's very painful. But because it's so rare, there's no treatment. So everything is trial and error. So that's what they started. We tried several chemotherapies over the years. When I went back and forth to Sick Kids, and then when I turned 18, I still had the cancer, and they had realized that there was another person in the U.S. that had it but had passed away. It was a little baby that didn't survive. So I'm the only survivor so far with this type of cancer. So when I turned 18, they moved me from Sick Kids, because it's for kids under 18, and moved me over to Princess Margaret. And Princess Margaret Medical Health Center for cancers. So I stayed there, over there, and I did chemotherapy and radiation. I've done chemotherapy and radiation quite a few times over the last 30 years. Yes, I said over 30 years. I have had cancer for over 30 years. 5 years ago was my last treatment. The chemotherapy over time has slowly broken down my body. Even though chemo is supposed to help the cancer, it's still poison, and the poison was hurting everything else in my system. So we had decided that there would be no more trial and errors, because I'm exhausted from that whole thing. They do make me comfortable at home to the best of their abilities. So yeah, that is why I have a walker, I have a cane, and I have my scooter, and I'm in a wheelchair. It depends on the day and how well I'm feeling each day. People ask me if I'm angry with the situation, and I always say, how could I be? It's the only thing I know. I don't know any other way but to fight, and I don't like to dwell on it, but I do feel like that I need to address it here, because it's not something I'm avoiding or ashamed of. It's just something that I will discuss and then move on, because I don't like to dwell on it. I don't like sympathy. I'm a very hard fighter. Like I mentioned yesterday in my video, I have been on my own since I was 15. I've done a lot of fighting on my own for a long time. So, I don't know how not to fight. I want my nieces and nephews to understand that not every day is a good day, but it's as good as you can make it. And for as long as you wake up tomorrow, that's great. That's the best day ever. You know, yesterday is your past. Today is your present. Tomorrow is not promised. So make sure you make the most out of today, because today is all that matters. I live life to the fullest. I don't go to bed with any regrets. I originally was going to start this YouTube channel back in April. And it was the first week of April that I sat down with my boyfriend and my parents, and we discussed about me starting up my YouTube channel. And my dad was getting things ready for my scooter so that I could record while I'm on my scooter, and we were preparing for me to start YouTube. A week before I started YouTube, I got hit by an SUV, and it destroyed my, it rode off my scooter, and I've had a hard 6 months trying to get back up on my feet. I am back up on my feet slowly. I'm not where I was before the accident. I really hope that I can get back to where I was before the accident. I crochet a lot, and the truck hit me on the left side. So crocheting was way out of my league because I was in so much pain. I am doing therapy, physiotherapy, trying to get my strength back. I also told you guys that I color for therapy. That is because I'm left-handed and I'm trying to get my strength built up in my left hand. So I color to try to get my arm back in motion and to be able to write my name and everything. It's been a hard 6 months, and I was really disappointed because I wanted to start my YouTube channel so bad. And I know a lot of things have changed here on YouTube, and I was very nervous to put this up, but then I realized that I have to speak my truth, my life. Because this is about me. I know there's been a lot of speculation about people saying they have cancer, or they do this or they do that, and this illness and that. I don't want to be known for my illness. I want to be known for me. And that's very important for me. But I also don't want to hide the fact that I have cancer, because my cancer might be having a better day than I am. Because yes, it lives inside me, and I classify it as its own being. And me, my own being. And we share this body, this vessel. You may hear me say, my cancer's winning today, but that doesn't mean I'm giving up the fight. You may hear me say, I can't do that because it's past my limitations. But you will never hear me say, I'm not going to give it a try, because that's not me. I only know how to fight. I told you guys recently that this was my next adventure, the next thing I wanted to put on my plate for me to try to overcome was to start YouTube, and that's why I'm doing it, because I'm strong and I want to overcome all my fears and live with no regrets. I want my nieces and nephews to know that they're very, very strong and that they come from a strong family background. And that I love them very much. I love my whole family. I'm sorry. I just need a minute. I also wanted to say that doing chemotherapy for as long as I have, there are some side effects that I'm dealing with now, which is, one, it has affected my insulin, and I'm diabetic now. I'm insulin dependent. The other is that it affected my thyroids, so now I take thyroid medication for the rest of my life. There are probably going to be a few more obstacles in my way because of the chemotherapy that I have taken over the years. They're not sure what it will be, but whatever it is, I'm going to face it head on, and I will get through it, because that's the only thing I know how to do. I want to thank each and every one of you for watching my YouTube channel and supporting me. I want you to please like, comment, and subscribe. And until next time,
till my next video. I love you guys. Bye.